Здравствуйте. Ассаламу алейкум. I'm here in Bishkek, the capital of Kyrgyzstan, and today we're getting into the top pros and cons for being an expat here in this Central Asian country. Let's do it. So, pro number one, the price. This country is incredibly cheap for expats. The local population here doesn't make that much money. I think the average salary is something like $200 to $300 per month. That means basically everything in even the capital city is really cheap, and the more you go out into the country, it's even cheaper. A beer in Bishkek is $1. Lunch in Bishkek is, you can get maybe $2, maybe $3. I'm renting my apartment for way over market value for $400 a month. If you were to get like a local price, you could definitely do like $100 to $200 for an apartment in a local part of the city here in Bishkek. And the best part for me is the taxis. The taxis here are incredibly cheap. You can take Yandex, which is the company, it's a Russian-based company, and Yandex taxis are less than a dollar, typically anywhere you go. Number two for me on the pros list is definitely the bar and restaurant scene here in the city. Bishkek, for whatever reason, it's a Central Asian country with not a lot of like easy connection to the outside, has a really, really good assortment of restaurants, whether it's Thai food, Indian food, Chinese food. They have really good local Kyrgyz food. They have Russian-inspired stolovayas. It's really good, and the food quality is pretty nice here. Even sushi is like a big thing here. And secondarily, the bars here are awesome. They have a lot of like underground bars, really hip, really cool, something you'd find in Berlin, something you'd find in New York City, very similar, but also very friendly places to hang out and to enjoy a night out. So bars and restaurants, delightful. Number three, I would say, is the apartments that you can find here. The apartments on Airbnb actually were pretty fair price, and a lot of them were generally pretty nice. They have a nice offering of refurbished and remodeled homes. You're not gonna find a lot of the terrible apartments for rent and Airbnb at least. And if you use a more local purveyor, the chance that you find something generally quite nice for a really good price, if you're staying here 6 months to a year, is also quite high. I went to a friend's house here. She's renting this huge flat, something like $300 a month. It's a really good price, and typically they're clean. They have cleaning services, and the landlords here, pretty nice, pretty helpful. If you don't speak Russian, could be hard, but in general, apartments, pretty good. My fourth pro about living here in Bishkek is that it's really diverse here. So you can get like a lot of different stuff. And the people in general are really, really friendly. So it's a Muslim country, but you get a lot of diversity with the Russians, with the different kinds of people who have come through here throughout history. And everyone's very welcoming and open, and they kind of have that Turkic kind of culture that everyone is here to serve you, to help you, to make sure that you're having a good time. If you look lost, someone will often try and help you. If they don't speak English, they'll try and talk to you anyway. It's really lovely, and the people have really made my experience here great. Whether it's been people helping me when I was sick, or people just generally talking to me on the street and being interested in where I'm from. It's a lovely place to be. My last pro for Bishkek is that you can blend in. If you've ever been to East Asia and you're any person that's not Asian, you're basically like a vegetarian at a barbecue restaurant. There's no way that you can blend in. But because they have a Russian presence here, there are some Anglo people living here and lots of foreigners, whether they're Uzbek or Turkish or whatever, or people working in embassies or for NGOs. So you typically, if you wanna like be a local person or feel a little bit like a local person, you can, which is nice. It's an option that I respect. And it's one of the only Asian countries I've ever been to where you can kind of feel included. Con number one for Bishkek is definitely the weather. The winter here is absolutely brutal. This is like the Asian steppe and it's mountainous, so you get insanely, insanely cold winters and wind and storms. And then in the summer, it's actually now, it's May, it's super beautiful out, it's 27 today, but I imagine when it gets a little bit later in the summer, it gets really quite scorchingly hot. So you kind of get the really, really hot in the summer, really, really cold in the winter thing. But they burn a lot of coal here as well, so the winters can be a little bit polluted. Con number two for an expat living here is that you definitely need to learn Cyrillic to be able to function here. If you know a little bit of Russian, that can go a long way, not super necessary. You should learn the numbers, but if you can't read Cyrillic, you're really like at a loss, meaning the letter and alphabet system of the Russians. So if you go to a restaurant, a lot of the menus don't have Latin transliterations. A lot of places like maps and things aren't transliterated. So learn Cyrillic. If you're gonna come here, you gotta learn Cyrillic. Con number three is that if you're a traveler like me, Bishkek is pretty isolated. It's close to other capitals if you're flying, so it's like 1 hour to Tashkent, 1 hour to Dushanbe. You can go to Almaty, Kazakhstan pretty easily. But if you're getting like bus travel within the country, Bishkek isn't really close to a lot of places, and the roads are not great, so it takes you a long time to travel. So travel here is a little bit tough, but if you're an adventurer, you can do it. Con number four and five in this case, is really with the fact that the driving here is pretty sketchy. It's a well-known fact within the country that a lot of the people that drive marshrutkas, which are the kind of like buses that transport people within Bishkek and then around the different regions of Kyrgyzstan, a lot of the drivers drink when they're driving. So that's pretty sketchy. And the road rules here are awful. Some of the worst drivers I've ever seen. Like in Istanbul, they kind of have a reason because they have 20 million people, but people here drive as aggressively, if not more aggressive, but there's not really any traffic, which leads to lots of really bad car accidents and lots of really, really sketchy driving scenarios. Driving, bad. For con number five, I'm gonna squat and I'm gonna tell you a story. So I took a trip to the east and we rented a car. They have really incredibly corrupt police in this country and they have really corrupt laws. So we did this road trip. This road trip is basically like something like 400 kilometers around Issyk-Kul, which is basically the eye of Central Asia, this very large central lake. And it's a place that a lot of Kyrgyz, Kazakhs, and people from all over the world come and visit and enjoy the summer. So we drove around this thing and the government decided that the speed limit for the entire freeway system crossing this entire chunk of Kyrgyzstan is 60 kilometers an hour. So that's 35 miles an hour, which basically nobody follows. And the entire reason why it's set up like that is so that they can fine people who are driving over the speed limit, because it's a speed limit that no one can follow, because if you want to make it from point A to point B, you're not going to go 35 miles an hour because it's egregiously slow. So what they've done is they've set up police checkpoints all over the place with police with like radar guns, and they just get you for driving over the speed limit, whether it's 10 kilometers an hour, which is about 3 or 4 miles over the speed limit. And since we're foreign, but actually not foreign, this is the whole thing, it's a bribe scheme. So the whole point is that they're setting this up in order to take bribes. And so a lot of the cops basically embezzle or steal a lot of money from the people of the country. And as a tourist, it was a really horrendous experience. My friend and I got pulled over 3 times on one road trip. The cops don't stop you for any reason other than just stopping you because you're driving. You're gonna have to pay a fine. And the second time we decided to not bribe them, and we decided to call, my friend had a lawyer here, and they let us go with a warning. But they also have speed cams that get you for fake infractions. So the whole system of driving in this country is awful, and the corruption is very felt. And most people in Kyrgyzstan just accept this. They just said, if you go on a trip, make sure you bring bribe money, which as an American, I cannot believe that. That's even kind of just something that people agree upon. So there's a really bad corruption within the lower level policing in this country. In Bishkek, I think they fixed it, but the rest of Kyrgyzstan, it's pretty bad. So that would be one thing that I would say, be aware. If you come to Kyrgyzstan and you're gonna drive, bring some bribe money. But hey, I don't want to end this on a negative note. So I will say Bishkek is one of my favorite places that I've lived over this 9-month digital nomad experience. It's an amazing city of parks, of good vibes, of nice people, good restaurants, and lots of good things going on. So if you can deal with some marginal corruption, I think this is the place for you. They have a beautiful sculpture garden here in the city center. This is called Panfilov Park. They even have a Ferris wheel. It's delightful. So that is life in Bishkek. I hope you guys come and visit. It's an amazing part of the world, an amazing, amazing place you need to visit. If you ever want to go someplace a little bit off the map, but still want to go someplace that's actually quite comfortable and culturally quite normal to you. If you like the video, make sure to like and subscribe, hit the notification bell, would help me out. And I think this might be our last video in Kyrgyzstan. We will see, stay tuned, and we will be headed to Uzbekistan next. So get ready for some Uzbek adventures, culture, and all that good stuff. Thank you for watching, and das fidanya.